President Marcos set to deliver his third State of the Nation address next week. He will again lay down the state of the country and its response to pressing problems. But as Archie Cruz tells us, Congress is not even halfway done with the wish lists he proposed in his previous speeches.
Among the top priorities from past State of the Nation addresses are bills amending laws on tax, electricity, rice tariffication, and mining in hopes of attracting investors to propel the economy.
Effectively, may long-term plan ang mga investors na may encourage dito. Tinitingnan din natin yung amendments to the EPIRA law para papagandaan natin yung energy sector natin para maibaba natin yung presyo ng kuryente. We will handle it by sections, pero kayang-kaya natin tapusin yan natin before siguro yung the Christmas break.
Also in advanced stages are bills against economic sabotage, reforming government procurement, fighting off financial account scams, revitalizing military self-reliance, maritime zones, reforms in education, government spending, and value-added tax on digital services.
Basta ang pinapangako ko, sisikapin namin gawin lahat ng pwede at kaya namin gawin nang hindi sinasakripiso ang kalidad o quality ng mga panukalang batas na aprubahan ng Senado.
Tagged the second priority are the proposed Blue Economy Act, universal healthcare reform, along with other reforms in governance, immigration, agrarian reform, and the return of mandatory ROTC. There are 19 other priority bills concerning other aspects of the economy, governance, trade, the military, fisheries, and aid to different sectors.
May carry over mula sa mga naunang LEDAC at may mga bagong panukalang batas din na pinag-usapan. Ang iba'y handa na, ang iba'y hindi pa handa. So, bahagi yun na magiging prioridad din ng Senado bilang pagtulong sa mga layunin ni Pangulong Marcos.
Passing the 6.352 trillion peso 2025 national budget is another priority.
Aabangan natin. Yan po ang magiging panukalang budget for 2025. Yan ang pinakamalaki, pinakamalaga kasi lahat po ng programa, lahat ng mga proyekto at initiatives ng ating presidente at ng administrasyon ni President BBM ay ilalata.
So far, only 17 out of over 60 priority bills have been enacted in the 2 years of the 19th Congress.
I give this administration high mark in terms of introducing economic infrastructure and even foreign investment bills. In the past 2 years, he has taken a different path from that of his predecessor. And 2024 is the year in which he has defined his presidency in terms of domestic and foreign policy.
Professor Tihanki observed that the list of bills needs more proposals on social and political reforms.
There's no mention of other important social legislation, like for example, the controversial divorce bill, and even the SOGI bill, which is important to a significant sector of our society. And then, of course, there are no mentions since in the past two SONAS, no mention of amending the age-old omnibus election code. The other one is, which is my favorite actually, the passing the Political Party Development Act. So modernizing the way we do politics.
Congress has to catch up with over half of the priority bills from previous SONAS.
Parati naman, perfect yung record natin eh. Parati naman natin tinatapos time on target. Kung hindi on time, karaming beses eh. Advance pa eh. Kung minsan, hindi pa nakalatag eh. Tapos na kami po.
Marami nang natapos. Ang namili kadalasan naman ay executive, kaya LEDAC yun. Hindi lamang isang pares ng mata ang susuri at titingin sa mga panukalang batas, kung hindi dalawang pares ng mata mula sa Kamara at mula sa Senado para matiyak na masusing na pag-aralan nito at walang nalampasan, ika nga, na maaaring makasama sa ating bansa, lipunan at mga kababayan.
Tihanki thinks it's possible that Congress may not finish all of the priority bills in time for the 2025 elections.
Of course, we know that the midterms is a preview to the bigger game in 2028, the next cycle of presidential election. Ang dapat na talagang bibigay ng direksyon sa mga kaalyado sa politika ay ang Pangulo.
In the coming months, the House and the Senate will tackle these priority measures on top of the new priorities that will be announced during the upcoming State of the Nation address, the last before the country heads to the next national elections next year. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Securities and Exchange Commission launches a probe into the use of a Navy officer's stolen identity to register nearly 200 corporations linked to offshore gaming hubs. Now, this is after Navy Lieutenant Jessa Mendoza told a Senate panel last week she was listed as an incorporator of 193 POGO-linked companies, even though she knew nothing about them. SEC Chairperson Emilio Aquino says the agency is probing how her name was included in all the companies. Aquino also points out the corporations were registered before the SEC implemented its digitalization program. He says he's confident cases like Mendoza's will not happen again. A low-pressure area has formed east of Mindanao. Let's get the latest now from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Veronica.
Good afternoon to you, Ron, and to all of our audience at ANC. So that's right, we're currently monitoring a low-pressure area, and at 3 p.m. today, it's estimated at 440 kilometers east of Davao City, and currently its expansion or trough is giving cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over eastern Visayas, Caraga, and Davao region. Meanwhile, southwest monsoon is affecting the western sections of southern Luzon and Visayas, and it's also bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over occidental Mindoro and Palawan. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. We don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country, but be careful for those who will be traveling over the western sections of Luzon and Visayas because the coastal waters there will be moderate rough. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thanks for that, Veronica.